So there's a new ritual that lots of us share right now, checking our temperature to see if we have a fever. And it's understandable. Fever is a common symptom of COVID-19. But if you're hoping your temperature is a nice 98.6 degrees or 37 Celsius, you might learn something new about yourself.
97.25?
98.2?
97.1.
Very low. Am I okay?
It turns out 98.6 degrees Fahrenheit isn't really the ideal or normal body temperature. There's really no such thing. But temperature can still tell us a lot about our health and about the spread of COVID-19. The number 98.6 mostly came from a 19th century German researcher named Karl Reinhold August Wunderlich. He claimed to crunch the numbers of more than a million temperature readings from thousands of patients, and he arrived at the number of 98.6. That number has stuck around ever since. But person to person, it's kind of meaningless. We asked our coworkers to take their own readings, and this is what normal temperature looks like for us.
95.83.
96.7, which seems low.
I'm a cold, cold man.
Might be a little bit higher than I would have thought.
That's fine, I guess.
Wunderlich himself knew that body temperature varied. He recorded a healthy range from 97.25 to 99.5 in his subjects. Other studies have shown that temperature can differ noticeably across age, gender, size, and race. And modern research points to a much lower number, around 98. That squares with our very informal staff average. We're around 97.5.
Either that or my thermometer's broken. I don't know.
What's more, you yourself don't have one body temperature. You have a range. Our team all took their readings at 10 a.m. But if you took yours a bunch over the course of a day, you'll see it change. Most people are coolest in the morning and warmest in the early evening. It's a reflection of your body's natural rhythms, your digestion, hormone production, cognition, and more. Here's what my temperature looks like throughout the day. Other bodily cycles like ovulation can cause small swings in temperature too, and different parts of you are different temperatures. Under the tongue, armpit, forehead, and rectal readings are all likely to be unique. Point is, there are tons of variables. We can be many temperatures all at once, all the time, and still be perfectly healthy.
But being sick is another story.
So I spoke with a couple people who are connecting some interesting dots between temperature variation and an illness like COVID-19. When you get sick, many of your body's natural, predictable rhythms start to destabilize. Your temperature might fluctuate more erratically, and it might crank up above your natural range. That's your body triggering a fever to make itself less hospitable to viruses or bacteria. In other words, your body temperature gets anomalous. That's trouble for you, but for people tracking COVID, it's crucial data. One effort is Kinsa, a company that tracks the spread of infectious disease using fevers. Kinsa sells a smart thermometer that sends your temperature back to the company every time you take it. Kinsa says they have about a million thermometers in circulation. And with all that data, they've built a real-time health weather map. It shows possible hotspots of COVID, counties with more fever than flu season would explain.
Let's take our real-time signal and remove the expected value of cold and flu. What's left over is a residual. That residual is atypical, in this particular analysis, atypical fever clusters, things that you would not expect. What we found since that point is that there's a very high correlation between our hotspots and COVID-19 cases.
The work is not peer-reviewed yet, and some experts question how reliable it can be with only a million thermometers. Their user base could also be biased by race or class or other factors. But Kinsa still thinks it can tease out some interesting trends, like the effect of social distancing. Here's their look at Miami-Dade County in the middle of March.
In 9 days, the percent of people with a fever more than doubled. And around the 17th and 18th, they started implementing the closure of bars. So it starts going down.
Other researchers are taking a different tack, looking for clues in body temperature that might predict a fever before it starts. One study out of UCSF will collect temperature and other health data from participants by using a smart ring. The rings can measure small changes in body temperature every minute. The question is, can tiny temperature rhythms predict a brewing infection like COVID?
And so we can pick up with great reliability those ultradian rhythms, those within a day rhythms, that are the frequency that tend to tell us about how stably are your hormones pulsing along, how synchronized are they inside of you.
It's early days for the study, but one smart ring user who tested positive for COVID has already shared some interesting data.
The temperature rhythms that I was seeing within the day start to sort of destabilize and amplify before they have a fever, right? Up to about 5 days beforehand. The whole system looked like it was sort of increasingly like a teeter-totter before they had a fever, before they felt sick.
Again, that's just one patient. But with enough data, the team hopes to build an algorithm that can sniff out COVID via rhythms like these.
We will be publishing the findings. We will be putting out, competitions or calls for sort of hackathon-y things of like, get everybody in the room. Let's get this as good as we can possibly get it. This is really just how big of a difference can we make, how quickly to get this into service.
In the coming months, while we take our temperatures every minute like maniacs, we're going to hear a lot more about the effort to track and predict COVID-19. Scientists will learn more about how the human body regulates itself and responds to disease. And along the way, we might let go of some assumptions about what's normal and healthy.
Obsessing about 98.6 is really false precision, right? Everybody should have a nice daily rhythm of their temperature. The only time your temperature is constant is when you're dead and it's room temperature. So thinking about the patterns of change rather than the absolute number is much more important.
Psst, cat, go on.
Cat, get out of there. Go on, go on, go on, go on, go on, go on, psst.